Today on AI News, how AI is being used on the front line in Ukraine, what AI and robotics together can do to treat spinal cord injuries, a robot arm that can be controlled by brain-computer interface for tetraplegic patients, Hopkins Space Lab is redirecting asteroids with autonomous spacecraft, BCI firm Neuroelectric's non-invasive brain stimulation to circumvent surgery, an AI skin patch that cuts heart tests from weeks to days while increasing accuracy. Scientists engineer robots with realistic pain expressions to train doctors. U.S. military bases deploy AI-powered robotic arm to prepare food for troops. And AI-designed protein able to awaken dormant genes. But first, make sure to subscribe. AI is on the front lines in Ukraine. Civil society groups and AI researchers have been increasingly alarmed in recent years about the advent of lethal autonomous weapon systems. AI-enabled weapons with the ability to select and eliminate people without human oversight. Ukraine has been using the Turkish-made TB2 drone, which can take off, land, and cruise autonomously, although it still relies on a human operator to decide when to drop the laser-guided weapons it carries. The drone can also use lasers to guide artillery strikes. Russia, meanwhile, has the Kamikaze drone with some autonomous capabilities called the Landsat, which it reportedly used in Syria and could use in Ukraine. The Landsat is technically a loitering munition designed to attack tanks, vehicle columns, and troop concentrations. Once launched, it circles a pre-designated geographic area until detecting a pre-selected target type, then it crashes itself into the target, detonating the warhead it carries. It's possible that China would provide Russia with more advanced AI-enabled weapons to use in Ukraine in exchange for gaining insights into how Russia effectively integrates drones into combat operations. An area in which Russia has battle-tested expertise from Syria that China lacks. AI might also play a vital role in the information war. Machine learning can also be used to help detect disinformation. AI can help analyze the vast amount of open-source intelligence coming out of Ukraine, everything from TikTok videos and Telegram posts of troop formations and attacks uploaded by average Ukrainians to publicly available satellite imagery. This could also allow civil society groups to fact-check the claims made by both sides in the conflict, as well as to document potential atrocities and human rights violations. Harnessing AI and robotics to treat spinal cord injuries. By employing artificial intelligence and robotics to formulate therapeutic proteins, a team led by Rutgers Research has successfully stabilized an enzyme able to degrade scar tissue resulting from spinal cord injuries and promote tissue regeneration. This study represents one of the first time artificial intelligence and robotics have been used to formulate highly sensitive therapeutic proteins and extend their activity by such a large amount. Soon after a spinal cord injury, a secondary cascade of inflammation produces a dense scar tissue that can inhibit or prevent nervous tissue regeneration. The enzyme successfully stabilized, CHABC, is known to degrade scar tissue molecules and promote tissue regeneration. Yet it is highly unstable at the human body temperature of 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit and loses all activity within a few hours. In order to stabilize the enzyme, the researchers utilized an AI-driven approach with liquid handling robotics to synthesize and test the ability of numerous copolymers to stabilize CHABC and maintain its activity at 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit. While the researchers were able to identify several copolymers that performed well, one copolymer combination even continued to retain 30% of the enzyme for up to 1 week, which is a promising result for patients seeking care for spinal cord injuries. A robot arm, a machine learning algorithm, and a brain-computer interface have been combined to create a means to help tetraplegic patients, those who can't move their upper or lower body, interact with their world. And the technology has been taken a step further by estimating and understanding brain signals without input from the patient. Researchers at the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology, Lausanne, employed a machine learning algorithm to interpret signals from the patient's brain and translate them into the articulation of the robot arm. The patient's brain activity was monitored by an EEG cap, which would then be sent through a computer to be interpreted by a machine learning algorithm. The algorithm translates the brain signals when the patient notices an error, inferring automatically when the brain doesn't like a certain action. In the team's research, they used the robot arm with a glass. The arm would move towards the glass, and the patient's brain would decide if it felt it was too close or too far away. The process repeated until the robot understands the optimal route for the individual's preference. Through the machine learning algorithm, the robot can gain a better understanding of variability to predict brain signals in certain situations. Implementing the algorithm into a wheelchair is an example of where the technology could go in the future. The algorithm could interpret brain signals to understand a user's speed preference, the distance they are happy to be from obstacles and people, and even the level of risk they are willing to take in certain circumstances, for example, if they're late or somewhere busy. By allowing the algorithm to understand the signals from your brain, it can interpret exact feelings that an individual couldn't explain themselves. Hopkins Space Lab is redirecting asteroids. Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Laboratory in Laurel, Maryland, is making waves and catching attention in the space infrastructure industry. The APL works with NASA on the Double Asteroid Redirection Test, DART for short, which is a combined effort to create the world's first full-scale planetary defense test for protection against asteroids. The Double Asteroid Redirection Test is an autonomous spacecraft launching with a SpaceX orbital shuttle that will branch off before the DART hits the asteroid Dimorphos. The impact is expected to change the speed of the asteroid by a fraction of a percent. Brain-computer interface firm Neuroelectrics wants to eliminate surgery with non-invasive brain stimulation. The Barcelona and Boston-based Neuroelectrics has been working on a non-invasive brain stimulation technology that can help patients living with seizures, sleep disorders, and autism. Their headgear is laced with small electrodes that inject currents into the brain, which either excite or inhibit neural activity, depending on the wearer's need. Neuroelectrics co-founder and CEO claimed that wearing the gear for 20 minutes, 10 days in a row, reduces seizures in users by 50%. The company uses its non-invasive electrical stimulation headgear to provide a new form of non-invasive neuromodulation to send electrical currents into the wearer's brain. It can use these currents to reduce excitation in specific regions of the brain, and the technology also allows for remote monitoring. And last year, Neuroelectrics received the green light from the Federal Drug Administration to conduct clinical trials on human patients suffering from depression. AI Skin Patch can cut heart test waiting time from weeks to days with more accurate results. An AI skin patch that carries out electrocardiographs, ECG, at home cuts the average waiting time for the heart test from 6 weeks to a matter of days. The device gives much better results, detecting more than 99% of atrial fibrillation and other irregular heart rhythms, compared to less than half, 46.5%, under the existing system. At the moment, people with suspected arrhythmias go into the hospital for 24 to 48 hours with an ECG, where they wear a cumbersome monitoring device known as a Holter. Under the AI system, patients go to the hospital, have a waterproof 10-square-inch patch put on their chest, and go home again. They wear the patch for 14 days and post it back for analysis by artificial intelligence within 10 minutes. Patients will now benefit from greater speed and accuracy of diagnosis. Scientists engineer robots with realistic pain expressions to train doctors to make treatment less painful and less biased. Robots with more accurate expressions of pain on the face give doctors in training an improved method for practicing on potential patients. Improving the accuracy of facial expressions of pain on these robots is a key step in improving the quality of physical examination training for medical students. The robots come in all kinds of shapes and hues. Previous studies attempting to model facial expressions of pain relied on randomly generated facial expressions shown to participants on a screen. The U.S. Department of Defense is deploying automated chefs to 10 U.S. military bases. The robotic arms use AI and computer vision to interact with their surroundings and use standard kitchen utensils to prepare various meals. The 10 robots will cost the department $1.6 million to reduce food waste, improve sanitation, and keep facilities adequately staffed, and they serve around 950 people a day. AI-designed protein able to awaken dormant genes. By combining CRISPR technology with a protein designed with artificial intelligence, it is possible to awaken individual dormant genes by disabling the chemical off switches that silence them. The approach will allow researchers to understand the role individual genes play in normal cell growth and development, in aging, and in such diseases as cancer. The AI-designed protein was developed at the UW Medicine Institute for Protein Design. The new technique controls gene activity without altering the DNA sequence of the genome by targeting chemical modifications. Scientists are interested in the epigenetic modifications because they affect gene activity and normal cell function, accumulate with time, contribute to aging, and can affect the health of future generations as we pass them on to our children. The goal of the UW researchers was to find a way to block PRC2 so that only one gene at a time would be affected. To do this, David Baker and his colleagues use AI to create a protein that would bind to PRC2 and block a protein the PRC2 uses to modify the histones. With these two advances, AI-designed proteins and CRISPR technology, we can now find the precise epigenetic marks that are important for gene expression, learn the rules and utilize them to control cell function, and drive cell differentiation and develop 21st century therapies.